Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2022. Discover functions with the FX icon. I'll be podcasting this entire book. Click the I in the top right-hand corner to get to the playlist. All right, so we're trying to calculate a loan payment today. I want to buy a new car, $25,995, pay for it over 60 months, 5.25% interest. How do I calculate the payment? Well, you know, there's all kinds of questions like this in Excel. How do I do this? How do I do that? What's the formula for? And out here on the Formulas tab, there is a huge button called Insert Function. You don't have to use this one, though, because it's been right here to the left of the formula bar for the last 30 or 40 years. Choose Insert Function. That can't be 40 years. For the last 30 years. All right, so we're going to search for a function. I'm going to search for loan payments or car payments. And when I click Go or just press Enter, it shows me all of the functions related to loan payments. For each one, I can see what arguments they need, and it tells me what it's going to do. Calculates the payment for a loan based on constant payments and a constant interest rate. That's the one that I need, all right? But the best part is, other than finding the name of the function, because I came in through Insert Function, when I click OK, they take me to the function arguments. And this is really important because there's five arguments here. The three bold arguments are required. The two non-bold arguments are optional. But as I click in, it gives me help for each of the arguments. Rate is the interest rate per period for the loan. For example, use 6% divided by 4 for quarterly payments at 6% APR. This is why I always screw this formula up, because I just use 5.25%, but that's an annual rate. So I have to divide by 12. And look, they even show me that's 0.004375. And today, I don't care at all, but someday that might be useful to see. End pair, what is end pair? Just click in. Oh, total number of payments for the loan. That's what I call the term. That's this. PV, present value. In other words, the price of the car. Now, one thing I've learned over time is that if I put a positive number here, the payment's going to be negative. But I never write a check for negative $425. I always write a check for positive $425. This is money coming out of the bank, so I put a minus sign here and then click on $25,995. Future value is a residual value then? Well, there might be, but it's not factored into the loan. Are we paying on the first of the period or the end of the period? I'll just leave it blank and say that I'm paying at the end of the month. All right, and you see, as soon as you get the three bold arguments in, the required arguments, you have an answer. $493. How awesome is that? Click OK. All right, so you don't know what function to use, come up here, click the FX button. And by the way, if you do know what function to use, if you do know that's payment, as soon as you type that open parenthesis, you can press Ctrl+A, and it'll bring you into function arguments. All right. So if you know the name of the function, you just need help getting through it, then just type that the function name, opening parentheses, and Ctrl+A to get there as well. This tip and many more tips are in MrExcel XL, the 40 greatest Excel tips of all time. Click the I in the top right-hand corner, and you'll have lots of ways to be more efficient in Excel, have more fun at work, all kinds of good things. All right, thanks to my friend Tony DeJonker in the Netherlands and Kat Parkinson for suggesting the function arguments dialog box as one of their favorite tips. There are over 400 calculation functions in Excel. If you don't know what function to use, click the FX button. It's right there to the left of the formula bar. Type what you're trying to do and click Go to do a search. Results show you the function related to your search term. When you click OK, you're not just left to figure it out. They take you through the function arguments dialog. It gives you help on each argument. Get all the bold arguments in, and you'll see the answer in two places in the dialog. If you already know the name of the function, type the name of the equal sign, name of the function, open parentheses, and then press Ctrl+A. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.